we would look at anywhere between a 30% plus type of a CAGR over the next 5 years. So I would, if I were to take a longer horizon, I think this would be one of the brands which we would expect to be amongst the fastest 100 crore brands in the country. So I would see it as two milestones, a 100 crore milestone, the brand launch. There are three things that we see as very clear trends that is emerging in the FMCG space today. First, beyond urban, I think the rural aspirations are increasing. Despite the challenging situations that we have faced in the last 3-4 years, one silver lining that we see in the industry today is that rural aspirations are equally increasing, and this is leading to an increasing consumption demand in rural. The second space that is defining the growth today is e-commerce is actually creating a disruption in a lot of spaces in the FMCG industry today. This is leading to a lot of new brands, new companies launching and scaling up significantly as we see. While the old legacy companies are being challenged by the new companies, there's an interesting mix of old economy and new economy coming together and the industry expanding. E-commerce is actually playing a very big role in this. The third big thing that we see from a consumer perspective, individual consumption-led growth is becoming far, far more important today. When I say individual-led consumption, it is just not about a family. It is just not about what the family is buying today, but I think individually people are becoming more aspirational, people are becoming more financially independent, and this is actually leading to a lot of individual-based consumption as we see. India, as we know, is actually a country of disproportionate youth population, and that demographic dividend is actually translating into a lot of consumption-led growth, and that we are seeing it both in rural as well as in the urban space, defined very clearly by some of the channels like e-commerce, modern trade, and the general trade in general. This is an important thing that we felt. As a company, we've been operating in this space. We've been operating in different categories across the consumption ladder, with personal care being one of the very specific growth engines that we've got. These trends enable us actually to be able to leverage some of the opportunities. And as we've been speaking earlier and as we've been seeing, we've been predominantly in the initial stages of the company being a sachet-led company, and over a period of time, we've transformed ourselves to become brand-led, and we've also been transforming ourselves to become non-sachet-led as well. This initiative today is one of our initiatives to take the company into the next big area. The next big area that we are focusing on is men's grooming. I'll take you through why men's grooming is actually an important segment that we have. It is one of the fastest growing categories in the personal care space today. Grooming as a concept is actually increasing across the country. Whether you call it with the rural youth, whether you call it with the urban population, men, women, kids, I think grooming is becoming an important part of the socioeconomic fabric today, and that's leading to a huge growth category that we see. Over the last 10 years, 15 years, we've seen this very dominant and predominant with the women segment. Women as a category have been huge consumers of grooming products over a period of time. They have been now translating into a lot of new products getting generated, new brands getting launched. And if you were to go to YouTube today, you would see a lot of self, do-it-yourself sort of campaigns, influencers on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, largely led by women. So the women's category has been a largely stabilized category in terms of grooming. But one key change that we are seeing now, right, and I'm sure that a lot of us in the room as well, men are also equally becoming cognizant of the fact that grooming is an important part of their personal life. And over a period of time, the industry is witnessing a lot of growth in the grooming segment, particular to the men's grooming. As we can see, it's a segment that's growing at almost 2.5. It's a segment that's grown at almost 2x in the last few years and expected to grow at more than 2.5 times in the next 5 years. It's a significant category. The category so far has been played only by a few players, especially dominated by the shaving segment, which is not, when you call men's grooming, normally you call it a shaving. Ironically, today, a very significant part of men's grooming is not people like me, not clean-shaven people like me, but youth in general. I don't know, if you were to look at from a demographic perspective in this room itself, or you go outside, below 45, you don't see people clean-shaven. Above 45, you largely see people clean-shaven, right? That's a very different direction that the grooming industry is taking today. The youth today are self-conscious about grooming as much as the older generation, which is also earning as well. These two opportunities are opportunities that we thought we will leverage, right? And one of the key reasons for that, I think, is the demographic dividend of the country, as I said. Second is, I think, as the income population starts rising, this is one of the areas that people are spending time. And why do they spend time? It is not that this is something that they're doing it only for the sake of being attractive. I think that has been a segment that probably has been like slowing down. Our key insight into men, whether it is on the mid segment or the high segment, a lot of association of men has been with bikes, both on the higher end of the segment as well as in the mid segments as well. And we believe, therefore, this is a brand that would actually take us to the next level in terms of being able to cater to the men's grooming segment. Why bikers? What is bikers all about? Before I go on to that, what is bikers all about? Bikers as a brand is our attempt to be able to help understand the problems that bikers have and men at large have and provide solutions to them through an array of products across the grooming space, the personal care space. So it is not going to be one product alone, it is going to be a portfolio of products that would get launched across the spectrum of the products. The portfolio would start obviously with something that we are strong at, and we will enter into a lot more segments as we move forward. But this is our attempt, our sincere attempt to be able to grow the business by actually providing solutions to men. And I think this is, in our view, this is one of the immediate opportunities that we have that we would like to leverage with. So what is so different? I said 150 brands have already got launched. So what is going to be different about this brand? Why would anybody want to actually look at this brand, right? Other than our understanding, our insights about men, and therefore our solutions to men for different problems, I think one key thing that we have picked up is men have very different hair problems. Now, the whole category is split into hair care and skin care. Skin care is what you see typically as your face creams, face washes, and the other stuff. Hair care is what typically men see from the hair perspective. If I may just take a break, and if I'm allowed, can I just see a show of hands of people who use, or men who use very particularly their own brands at home? Does any of you guys here have your own brand as far as men is concerned, or do you just go with what your family buys? A small raise of hands there. Yeah. I think this is the problem that we're trying to solve to start with. When you look at the men's segment, and when we looked at shampoos as a segment, we did not find that men's had a particular shampoo. Men always depend on, and this is a study that we have done in the bathroom panels that we do. We've always seen that men, as far as shampoos are concerned, right, creams, I think to some extent they've now started moving on. But as far as shampoos are concerned, men have always been using the same shampoo as what probably the family uses. And they've not found a need, or they've not found necessarily an urge to actually look at a different brand. What we have done today is we particularly identified this as a niche, and when we spoke to lots of consumers, men in particular, one thing that came out constantly is we travel a lot. Many of them travel by bike, many of them travel by car, many of them travel by public transport and utilities as well. But one thing that came common was there is no single solution that is being provided to men in particular as far as the shampoo is concerned, right? And so that we thought we'll take it as an anchor for our brand. And this has been a constant work of the last 2 years plus, where we've leveraged our R&D, our whole research setup, to be able to come back with one of the few good shampoos that we could bring in. And that's the first set of products that we're launching. It is a product that is aimed at men, but this is a category that we believe is a first of sorts in India. There have been attempts made in the past, but we've not seen any brand being able to scale up fully. And this is our first attempt to actually give a customized solution to men at large, and in particular, the problems that bikers have, and hence the name bikers, we said. So we are looking at a brand that provides solutions to bikers, the problems and the opportunities that bikers have, and therefore the brand cuts across the hair care and skin care segments. Starting off with this we believe is a very, very niche, innovative product that we've not seen. While shampoos at large have been there across the market, this is the first time that we are seeing that we probably would have a shampoo customized for men, right? And what's the hero product, and why the significance of this helmet? It is because I think the The one at the center, the helmet shampoo, something I think it's a first of sorts. While you have multiple other shampoos getting created, the helmet as a shampoo is the first of its lot that we are actually launching in India today. And true to its spirit, I think Kevin Cat leads this innovation. Many other brands have come in the space, but they have not attempted this particular unique attempt, and therefore I think this is the first launch that we're bringing in from Biker's perspective. As you all know that Kevin Care has been a pioneer in moves to the FMCG categories in the country today. Be it in personal care, be it in shampoos, be it in milkshakes. Kevin Care has always been taking this path of innovation to be able to drive growth across most of the FMCG categories. Today is one occasion where we're launching a new brand. We're first getting into men's grooming category. Why men's grooming? One big trend that we see in industry today is that unlike the earlier years, today we are seeing a lot of spends from the men's grooming segment. Men in general have been spending a lot of their money in grooming themselves, not just in apparels, not just in watches or accessories, but the personal care stroke beauty segment has also been significantly increasing as far as men's consumption is concerned. We would like to leverage the space and also create innovation in the space. So today we are actually announcing the foray of Kevin Care into men's grooming as a segment with the launch of Biker's as a brand. Biker's as a brand is aimed at providing solutions to men at large and bikers in particular. One of the key areas that we have seen of concern for men has been their hair care segments, right? And when you look around the set of products that we haven't seen a lot of shampoo-based products for men. Men in general use common shampoos. There's not been a male-specific shampoo in particular. So we're starting the brand launch of Biker's with a very specific launch of shampoo for men. It's called a helmet repair shampoo, where we believe that we will be able to provide solutions to men, especially in the Biker's segment. As a follow-up to this, we'll have a lot of other subcategories that the brand gets into. The brand would eventually be available across 10 lakh outlets that Kevin Care has got across the country. It will also be very significantly available in modern trade as well as the e-commerce outlets. So we very strongly believe that this is one more area of growth opportunity for us. And a lot of work that we have done in the recent past, in a lot of investments that we have done in terms of research and development, we know these products. We believe Biker's as a brand will be a very significant brand in our portfolio, and the launch of the shampoo to start with is a journey that we can start. Thank you. Of this product is going to be available in the general trade format as well. We would also have a sachet variant of this product available as well. So general trade availability will also be equally high for the brand. Some of the subcategories of the brand, shampoos for example, would be widely spread across general trade, modern trade, as well as e-commerce. Some of the new age subcategories, they would be available largely on e-commerce. That's the way we would split it. Beard care, beard related categories or new gen categories as we would see it, they have been largely driven by the e-commerce category. And Radha, if you may add to the ones. So beard care is one segment. That is for sure a segment which is going to be isolated. We see body care as a segment being driven largely by e-commerce again. So these are two segments that we believe will be e-commerce stroke modern trade oriented. The hair care segment at large is spread across the categories.
Kevin Care Nirvanam Sarvaga Inadu Mudakkan Nandri. இன்றைக்கி வந்து நாங்கள் ஒரு புது கேட்டகரி லான்ச் பண்ணுறோம். இட்ஸ் கால் மென்ஸ் க்ரூமிங். இன் ஜென்ரல் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அ லாட் ஆஃப் பர்சனல் கேர் பியூட்டி ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ் பை விமன். பெண்கள் நிறையா பியூட்டி கேர் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க. பியூட்டி கேர் இன் த சென்ஸ் நாட் ஜஸ்ட் பியூட்டி கேர் அலோ, க்ரூமிங், ஸ்கின் கேர் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ், அ லாட் ஆஃப் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் வி சி யூஸ் பை விமன். ஆஃப் லேட் ஒரு புது ட்ரெண்ட் உருவாகிட்டு இருக்கு. வி சி அ லாட் ஆஃப் மென், பெரிய டவுனாக இருந்தாலும் சரி, சின்ன டவுனாக இருந்தாலும் சரி, வி சி அ லாட் ஆஃப் மென் யூஸிங் பியூட்டி கேர் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ், க்ரூமிங் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ். அண்ட் இன் ஜென்ரல் திஸ் இஸ் அ ட்ரெண்ட் தட் யூ சீன் வித் த யங் பீப்புள் அஸ் வெல். So we are now as a company launching into a new category called men's grooming. Men's grooming, the first product now, we are launching a new brand called Bikers. What is this brand about? Bikers now, this is a brand that understands the problem of men in particular and bikers. So whether you ride a normal bike or whether you go on long road trips, this brand helps you solve your problems. As a first step, நாங்கள் ஷாம்பூ லான்ச் பண்ணுறோம். வை ஷாம்பு நீங்கள் ஜென்ரலாக பார்த்தீங்கன்னா த ஷாம்பூஸ் ஆர் அவைலபிள் ஃபார் விமன். இன் ஜென்ரல் ஆண்கள் வந்து ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்காக பிரத்யேக ஷாம்பூன் யூஸ் பண்ணுறது கிடையாது. தே யூஸ் அ லாட் ஆஃப் எக்ஸிஸ்டிங் பிராண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ வி வாண்ட் டு கிரியேட் அ பிராண்ட் ஃபார் மென் இன் பர்டிகுலர். ஆஸ் அ ஃபாலோ அப் ஆஃப் இந்த பர்டிகுலர் பிராண்ட் இஸ் வெரி ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் டு மென். அதுலேயும் ஷாம்பூஸ் வி ஹவ் லான்ச் இட் ஃபார் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம். In India, not many brands are very specific to men. And this is the first product we're launching. Over a period of time, in the brand in Vailaha, we will have a lot more of new products coming in the grooming side. So we look forward to success.
Thank you. Yeah, which will be pitching. And bringing in a sharper focus towards the new consumer segments, making ourselves relevant in today's scenario to a lot more consumer segments, and being able to actually get closer to an opportunity that we feel is a big, big opportunity as we move forward in the industry. Yeah, this is the full range as we speak. As we get into the launch phase, we would see a lot of the whole range coming in, including shampoos, beard oil, beard gel, the beard grooming segment, the face care segment, the body care segment. As we speak, over a period of time, these products will be available, and we will be actually making these available across all formats of stores, general trade, modern trade, as well as in e-commerce as well. So thank you, and that's from my side. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Incremental investments are not being so high, but we're leveraging the knowledge and the experience that we have gained in hair care over the last 30 years to be able to actually bring in more innovative products. Overall, the category